Newton's universal law of gravitation states that every particle in the universe attracts every other particle with a force along a line joining them. Gravity is dependent only on the masses involved and the distance between them. Gravity is the force that gives objects weight and keeps planets and satellites in orbit. That force, also called gravitational pull, is measured by how fast objects accelerate towards each other. The Earth's gravitational pull keeps NASA rockets on the launch pad. After blastoff, the gravitational force decreases as the rocket quickly accelerates away from Earth. Space has very low pressure and is a near-perfect vacuum. In a vacuum, air resistance is eliminated and all objects accelerate at the same rate. On Earth, acceleration due to gravity is 32.2 feet per second squared, also simply known as 1G. The gravity is smaller on the surface of planets with less mass. So, in comparison, lunar gravity is about 1/6 of Earth's, and Mars's gravity is about 3/8 that of Earth's. Microgravity is a condition of free fall within a gravitational field in which a physical object's weight is reduced compared to its weight at rest on Earth. 250 miles above Earth, the International Space Station is traveling about 17,000 miles per hour in its orbit around the Earth's surface. As it free falls, the space station and the astronauts inside are experiencing about 90% of the gravity we feel on Earth. The difference is the spacecraft and everything inside it are in the same gravitational field and are all falling together, creating a constant microgravity environment perfect for scientific research. Studying things in different environments gives researchers a better picture of how they work.
Roger, 0G, and I feel fine. Capsule is turning around. Oh, that view is tremendous.
Back here on Earth, we feel our weight because of gravity and whatever is preventing us from falling, like the scale and the floor. That's why you feel almost weightless at the top of a roller coaster, because you are starting to fall under the acceleration of gravity. But the rush of air adds resistance, and the ground adds weight. So naturally, microgravity does not exist on Earth. But microgravity can be created on Earth in Cleveland, at NASA's Glenn Research Center. Here, inside the largest drop tower in the world, a near-weightless environment is achieved for 5.18 seconds by allowing objects to freefall in a vacuum over 400 feet.
The Zero Gravity Research Facility is a registered National Historic Landmark. It was opened in 1966 during the space race era to support research and development of spaceflight components and fluid systems in a weightless environment. This unique facility provides a microgravity test environment for a fraction of the cost and preparation time of experimenting in space. Here, researchers conduct experiments by installing them in a drop vehicle that freefalls inside of a steel vacuum chamber. Removing the air from the chamber prior to the drop minimizes air drag on the falling drop vehicle. This method decreases the apparent gravitational pull on the freefalling package from 1G to almost 0G. Here's how it works. Experiments weighing up to 1,000 pounds and up to 3 feet in diameter are loaded into a 1,500-pound, 13-foot-tall drop vehicle. The drop vehicle contains battery packs that provide power for the experiment, high-speed video cameras, and data acquisition and control systems. During the drop, test parameters are recorded, such as pressure, temperature, and gas or liquid flow rates. Video cameras with recording speeds as high as 4,000 frames per second record images of the experiment. Once an experiment has been readied for testing, the drop vehicle's skins are attached to enclose the hardware. Using the 3-ton crane, the crane operator picks up the release mechanism, or A-frame, and positions it over the drop vehicle. The A-frame and drop vehicle are hooked together, and the crane operator moves the pair to the top of the vacuum chamber. The drop vehicle is suspended at the top of the chamber by a hinged plate, held closed by a specially designed bolt, which will be fractured when the drop vehicle is released. Technicians then attach a large electrical connector to the top of the drop vehicle. This allows the test engineers in the control room to communicate with the experiment power, data, and control systems before the drop. Once these activities are complete, the safety cables are removed so that nothing is holding up the drop vehicle except one large bolt and two safety pins, which prevent the release jaws from opening. The crane lifts, moves, and lowers a steel dome over the A-frame and drop vehicle, sealing the vacuum chamber. Two keyed steel rods are inserted through the dome to allow the technicians to pull the safety pins once the air is removed from the chamber and the experiment is prepped. With five vacuum pumps located in the facility and the help of GRC's central process services, air is pumped out to produce a vacuum. During the hour-long process, technicians monitor air pressure, which is reduced from normal atmospheric pressure, about 760 torr, to about 0.1 torr. Once the desired vacuum is reached, engineers power up the experiment. Communicating through the connected cable, they can see live video to configure the experiments and execute pre-drop sequences. After the safety pins are removed, the experiment is ready to be dropped. Pushing the fire button starts the drop sequence and the experiment timing. The large electrical connector is pulled from the top of the drop vehicle, and a hydraulic cylinder is activated that applies a load to the top of the hinged plate release mechanism. This load, combined with the weight of the drop vehicle, breaks the bolt holding the hinged plates closed, releasing the drop vehicle to begin its freefall. With virtually no air drag, the drop vehicle freefalls 432 feet. The experiment ends when it lands in a 20-foot-deep container full of expanded polystyrene beads. It's traveling about 113 miles per hour when it hits the deceleration material and is stopped in 12 to 15 feet. The load on the drop vehicle and experiment is about 35 Gs during the deceleration. Once the vacuum chamber has been vented back to standard atmospheric pressure, the crane operator takes off the dome and A-frame and lowers a cable to the decelerator to retrieve the drop vehicle. Technicians descend to the bottom of the shaft in an elevator and vacuum up the deceleration material around the drop vehicle. They attach the crane to the drop vehicle and lift it up through the vacuum chamber and back over to its stand on the shop floor. Next, the skins are removed and experiment data is downloaded to a hard drive and provided to the scientist or researcher to analyze exactly what happened during those 5.18 seconds of microgravity.
Gathering valuable scientific data like this is an essential part of NASA's purpose to pioneer the future in space exploration, aeronautics research, and scientific discovery. One such discovery with fire in microgravity has shown that instead of the upward pointing flame, it produces a spherical shape. Researchers also have found that under some conditions, materials can burn in microgravity which would extinguish on Earth due to convective heat loss. Understanding how fire spreads and behaves in space is crucial for the safety of astronauts and for controlling fires on Earth. There are many reasons why experiments are conducted at the Zero-G research facility instead of the space station. It only takes a fraction of the time and cost to plan and execute tests here that require less than 5 seconds of microgravity. It's also easier and a shorter turnaround time to test new concepts and ideas that might not work out or could prove to be a safety risk for spacecraft and crew. Researchers around the world use this facility to prove the reliability of their hardware designs for space station experiments, thereby reducing the risk of failure in space. Studying physical sciences in microgravity helps us understand systems in a whole new way. The Zero Gravity Research Facility advances that scientific knowledge, one drop at a time.